Hello dear students, this is the first session on the postmodern novel The French Lieutenant's Woman. The novel is a postmodern historical fiction by John Fowles, published in 1969. It was his third published novel after The Collector, which was published in 1963, and The Magus, published in 1965. The French Lieutenant's Woman explores the fraught relationship of an amateur naturalist, Charles Smithson, and Sarah Woodruff, a disgraced and abandoned woman. She is the central character or the protagonist of the novel. John Fowles was an English novelist of international fame. He was critically positioned between modernism and postmodernism. He was born on Lay-on-Sea in Essex, England, as the son of Gladys May Richards and Robert John Fowles. Fowles spent his childhood attended by his mother and by his cousin Peggy Fowles, 18 years old at the time of his birth. Fowles was an athletic standout during his school days. After leaving Bedford School in 1944, Fowles enrolled in a naval short course at Edinburgh University. He did military service till 1947. After his military service, Fowles entered New College, Oxford, where he studied both French and German. It was at Oxford that Fowles got influenced by reading existentialists like Jean-Paul Sartre and Albert Camus, and started considering writing as his career. Fowles spent his early adult life as a teacher in Spetses, Greece, where he met his future wife Elizabeth Christie. She was then the wife of his fellow teacher Roy Christie. His experiences in Spetses helped him in drafting the setting of his second novel, The Magus, which was published in 1966. He was later dismissed from the school on the charges of instituting unfavorable reforms in the school, and he returned to England. He later married Elizabeth. For nearly 10 years, Fowles taught English as a foreign language to students from other countries at St. George's College in London. While talking about the literary career of John Fowles, his first novel, The Collector, was published in 1963. The book was a bestseller and a great beginning for Fowles. It was adapted into a feature film of the same name in 1965. His second novel, based on his experience in Greece, The Magus, was published in 1966. He adapted The Magus for cinema, and the film was released in 1968. In 1965, he moved to Lyme Regis, where he spent most of his remaining life. He served as the curator of the Lyme Regis Museum from 1979 to 1988. Lyme Regis became the setting of his third novel, The French Lieutenant's Woman, which was published in 1969. In this novel, Fowles created Sarah Woodruff, one of the most enigmatic female characters in literary history. The novel was released to critical and popular success. It was eventually translated into more than 10 languages and established Fowles' international reputation. It was adapted as a feature film in 1981. The screenplay of the feature film was done none other than Harold Pinter. Some other notable works of Fowles include The Ebony Tower, published in 1974, Daniel Martin, published in 1977, Mantissa, 1981, A Maggot, 1985, etc. He was named by the Times newspaper of UK as one of the 50 greatest British writers since 1945. Now, while talking about the novel, The French Lieutenant's Woman. The French Lieutenant's Woman was the most popular work of John Fowles. It had numerous editions and was translated into many languages. In 2005, Time magazine chose the novel as one of the 100 best English language novels published between 1923 and 2005. The novel throws light on Fowles's familiarity with Victorian literature. Part of the novel's reputation is based on its expression of postmodern literary concerns through thematic focus on metafiction, historiography, meta-history, Marxist criticism, and feminism. The Canadian literary theorist Linda Hatcheon identifies the novel as an example for a particular postmodern genre, historiographic metafiction. The term historiographic metafiction was actually coined by Linda Hatcheon herself in the late 1980s. It incorporates three domains: fiction, history, and theory. She used the term for works of fiction which combine the literary devices of metafiction with historical fiction. Works regarded as historiographic metafiction are also distinguished by intertextuality, that is, frequent allusions to other artistic, historical, and literary texts. In order to show the extent to which works of both literature and historiography are dependent on the history of discourse, the term is closely associated with works of postmodern literature, usually novels. Linda Hatcheon finds a contrast between the independent Sarah Woodruff and the more stereotypical male characters in the novel. The novel is also noted for its treatment of gender issues. Fowles had even claimed it as a feminist novel, but the novel lacks a sufficiently transformative perspective on women. Following popular success, the novel created a larger legacy. The novel has had numerous responses by academics and other writers. In 1981, the novel was adapted as a film of the same name with a script by the playwright Harold Pinter. The novel was also adapted and produced as a British play in 2006. Fowles wrote about the writing process of the novel in his 1969 essay titled Notes on an Unfinished Novel. He said he had an image during the autumn of 1966. The image was that of a woman who stands at the end of a deserted quay and stares out to sea. He determined that she belonged to a Victorian age and had mysterious and vaguely romantic qualities. He wrote, "You are not trying to write something one of the Victorian novelists forgot to write, but perhaps something one of them failed to write. And remember the etymology of the word. A novel is something new. It must have relevance to the writers now, so don't ever pretend you live in 1867, or make sure the readers know it's a pretense." While talking about the plot of the novel, the major characters in the novel are Sarah Woodruff is the French lieutenant's woman. She is the title character in the novel. She is also known as the tragedy or the French lieutenant's whore. Charles Smith's son is an orphan and an amateur paleontologist. He is dependent on his uncle. He considers himself as a man of science. Ernestina Freeman is Charles's fiancée and the daughter of a wealthy tradesman. Sam is Charles's servant, and Mary is the maid of Ernestina's aunt, Mrs. Tranter. Then Sir Robert is Charles's uncle, and Mrs. Tompkins is a widow whom Sir Robert marries. This gives you an idea of some of the characters in the novel. Now, talking about the plot of the novel. The novel is set in the mid-19th century. It opens in the coastal town of Lyme Regis in 1867. As in other works of metafiction, the narrator of the novel frequently intervenes in the story with a personality of its own. The narrator identifies the novel's protagonist as Sarah Woodruff, the woman of the title, also known as Tragedy, and as the French Lieutenant's whore. Sarah Woodruff lives in the coastal town of Lyme Regis as a disgraced woman, supposedly abandoned by a French naval officer named Vergennes, who had returned to France and married. She works as a servant in the house of Mrs. Pulteney. She spends some of her limited free time on the co-op, a stone jetty where she stares out to sea, or at Ware Commons, which is a large wood. One day, Charles Smithson and Ernestina Freeman, Ernestina is Charles's fiancée, they see Sarah walking along the cliffside. Ernestina tells Charles something of Sarah's story, and he becomes curious about her. Though continuing to court Ernestina, Charles has several more encounters with Sarah, meeting her secretly 3 times. During these meetings, Sarah tells Charles of her history and asks for his emotional and social support. Charles's curiosity about Sarah soon ripens into a passionate relationship. This is how the story develops. He was actually going to marry Mrs. Ernestina Freeman, but his meeting with Sarah Woodruff changes the course of events. Meanwhile, there is a parallel love story that is going on in between Charles's servant Sam and Mrs. Tranter's maidservant Mary. Charles's hope of inheritance collapses when his wealthy uncle Sir Robert gets engaged to Mrs. Tompkins, a widow. Ernestina gets very much upset when Sir Robert gets engaged and thereby denying inheritance to Charles Smithson. Much of this has to do with the setting of the novel that is very much Victorian. There are lots of affairs, marriage proposals, marriages, extramarital affairs, inheritances, loss of inheritances, love triangles, better prospects of marrying a girl, etc., which are very much artistically woven together in the novel, which make a better recipe for a Victorian novel. Charles falls deeply in love with Sarah, and Sarah is dismissed by Mrs. Pulteney. Charles advises Sarah to leave Lyme Regis for Exeter, where she can have more freedom. Charles's fascination for Sarah actually stems out of his thought that she is free from all prevailing social institutions. He feels that a relationship with Sarah would make him also free. Sarah lives for Exeter. Charles feels very much worried about Sarah. He soon finds a note left to him by Sarah. These are the kinds of elements that we can find in a typical 19th century English novel. Sam also finds the note, and he figures out what is actually happening between his master and Sarah Woodruff. Sam is highly ambitious in life. He even thinks of blackmailing Charles to extract money so that he can have a secure life with Mary. Meanwhile, things get troubled in Winsett, means the house of Sir Robert. Mrs. Tompkins gets pregnant by the butler. Charles's uncle tells Charles that it was a mistake to marry her, and he promises Charles that he will not go unprovided for, which means Charles would still get his inheritance. Charles realizes that he can't forget Sarah. He also realizes and admits that he is marrying Ernestina not out of love but for her wealth. He then makes some decisions and sets out to warn Ernestina's father about his uncertain inheritance. Charles was actually expecting Ernestina's father ending the marriage proposal between him and Ernestina while hearing the news of his loss of inheritance. On his way back, he stops at Exeter to meet Sarah. From this point onwards, the narrative of the novel becomes a little tricky. From here, the self-conscious narrator who intervenes throughout the novel and later becomes a character in it offers three different conclusions to the novel. In the first ending, Charles does not visit Sarah, but immediately returns to Lyme to reaffirm his love for Ernestina. They marry, though the marriage never becomes particularly happy, and Charles enters trade under Ernestina's father, Mr. Freeman. The narrator pointedly notes the lack of knowledge about Sarah's fate. Charles tells Ernestina about an encounter which he implies is with the French Lieutenant Swore, but elides the sordid details, and the matter is ended. The narrator dismisses this ending as a daydream by Charles before the alternative events of the subsequent meeting with Ernestina are described. Critic Michelle Phillips Bushberger describes this first ending as a semblance of verisimilitude in the traditional happy ending found in actual Victorian novels. Before the second and third endings, the narrator appears as a character sharing a railway compartment with Charles. He tosses a coin to determine the order in which he will portray the other two possible endings. That actually emphasizes the equal plausibility of these two endings. In the second ending, Charles and Sarah have a rash sexual encounter in which Charles realizes that Sarah was a virgin. Reflecting on his emotions during this, Charles ends his engagement to Ernestina and proposes to Sarah through a letter. Charles's servant Sam fails to deliver the letter, and after Charles breaks his engagement, Ernestina's father disgraces him. His uncle marries and his wife bears a child, ensuring the loss of the expected inheritance. To escape the social suicide and depression caused by his broken engagement, Charles goes abroad to Europe and America. Ignorant of Charles's proposal, Sarah flees to London without telling her lover. During Charles's trips abroad, his lawyer searches for Sarah, finding her 2 years later living in the Chelsea house of the painter and poet Dante Gabriel Rossetti, where she enjoys an artistic creative life. Sarah shows Charles the child of their affair, leaving him in hope that the three may be reunited. Now the third ending. In the third ending, the narrator reappears outside the house at 16 Cheyne Walk and turns back his pocket watch by 15 minutes. Events are the same as in the second ending version until Charles meets Sarah. The new ending does not make clear the parentage of the child, and Sarah expresses no interest in reviving the relationship. Charles leaves the house, intending to return to the United States, wondering whether Sarah is a manipulative, lying woman who exploited him. So these are the three endings which the novelist leaves for the reader to decide which ending the reader wants to choose. So here we are putting an end to the first session on the French Lieutenant's Woman. In the coming sessions, we will be discussing on the theme, the narrative, structure, style, setting, and other matters related to the novel. Thank you.